here at the Tremont Athletic Club in Tremont, obviously, hanging out with personal trainer extraordinaire, Mary. How are you?
Good to see you.
She's awesome sauce. Now I'm not going to like it because she's going to make me do some stuff. So I said, Mary, let's talk about exercise in your 20s, 30s, 40s, and 50s. And there's different variations. You said one of the important things to remember, joint health.
Yes, so you want to set the foundation to keep your joints happy, healthy, and strong throughout all the decades of your life. That means mobile and pain-free and moving in all planes of motion.
I like pain-free.
Okay, pain-free,
so you're going to give us a little series. Okay, so talk about the different, we're going to do the same exercise, but different levels.
Different levels. So we're going to start at our most advanced, ideally your 20s, and then we are going to progress.
Okay.
So we are going to start with our jump squat. Now this is going to get our heart rate up, and this is also going to be power and speed.
All right.
So what we're going to do, we're going to sink down into our squat, and you are going to jump up. I want to see you jump. I don't want to hear you jump. It's going to get your heart rate going. If you notice, their sinking back weight is in their heels, and they're powering up in a nice soft landing in there. Now, as you progress through just your goblet squat, we could add some weight to it. Now, adding some weight to it is also going to engage the core a lot. Now, how she would regress this exercise, she would just lose her kettlebell, and she can just do body weight as well. So I'm going to have Jim show us that right here. He is going to sink back, weight in your heels, chest is upright, and core is tight, making this really easy on our joints. Think sitting in a chair and standing up. If you need something to go behind you, put a nice chair behind you or a bench, and that can make this
okay, next
easier.
Exercise, Mary.
Next exercise is going to be our push-up. So we are going to go down, shoulders in line with elbow, in line with wrist. We're going to come down, elbows stay in nice and tight, and we power up. We think of bringing chest down to the floor and powering back up. A regression of this would be on our knees. Again, she's keeping her core nice and tight, back flat, elbows nice and close to her body. To make this a little easier, you can do it on a wall, on a bench, on a chair. If you notice, again, his core is tight, engaged. He is keeping his elbows back and close to him.
And last but not least,
we have to work that core. Keeping your core strong will keep everything else strong. Here we are going to start with a plank tap. So if you notice, they are just taking opposite hand, tapping opposite shoulder, keeping hips tight, keeping themselves nice and aligned, nice and straight. Here, she is holding just her regular basic plank. Again, nice and in line, shoulders, elbows, wrists, tighten that core, everything engaged. She is like a straight line from her head to her heels. Our modified version would be our hover plank, and that is taking your knees bent, keeping that back flat, shoulders pinned together, core engaged. If he needs to reduce, again, he could just drop his knees to the ground and again, keep his belly button and his spine.
Excellent.
There you go.
Look at that, 20 to 50 in 30 seconds. Okay. Welcome to Workout in a Hurry with Mary. All right. When we come back, Mary has some more exercises for us, and I can talk and breathe at the same time for you, Wayne Dawson.
Yes, I see you, man. Oh, it's okay. You go, boy. You go.